Greetings, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to the Church of Our Lady of Lourdes, the celebration of the Eucharist. Today is for the third Sunday of Easter. The celebrant is Father Paul Yeo. For Mass intentions, for the faithful departed, Mary Li Lai King, Bertram Xia, Gladys Xia, Magdalene Lee, Aroksami Regina. For special intentions, Felicia Ang, Dick Goy, birthday blessings, God's mercy and compassion on the world, Keegan Palouse, Felicia Ang, Monica Yeo, Vincent Yeo, people suffering from COVID-19, all foreign workers in Singapore, good health and well-being, and all the poor destitute on the world.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let's pray for God's mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. May your people exalt forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. The first reading, a reading from the Acts of the Apostles. On the day of Pentecost, Peter stood up with the 11 and addressed the crowd in a loud voice. Men of Israel, listen to what I'm going to say. Jesus the Nazarene was a man commanded to you by God, by the miracles and portents and signs that God worked through him when he was among you, as you all know. This man was put into your power by the deliberate intention and foreknowledge of God. You took and had crucified by man outside the law. You killed him, but God raised him to life, freeing him from the pangs of Hades, for it was impossible for him to be held in its power since. as David says of him, I saw the Lord before me always, for with him at my right hand, nothing can shake me. So my heart was glad, and my tongue cried out with joy, my body too, with rest in the hope, that you will not abandon my soul to Hades, nor allow your Holy One to experience corruption. You have made known the way of life to me. You will fill me with gladness through your presence. Brothers, no one can deny that the patriarch David himself is dead and buried. His tomb is still with us. But since he was a prophet and knew that God had sworn him an oath to make one of his descendants succeed him on the throne, what he foresaw and spoke about was the resurrection of the Christ. He is the one who was not abandoned to Hades and whose body did not experience corruption. God raised this man Jesus to life, and all of us are witness to that. Now raised to the heights by God's right hand, he has received from the Father the Holy Spirit, who was promised. And what you see and hear is the outpouring of that Spirit. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm, the responses, show us, Lord, the path of life.
Show us, Lord, the path of life.
Preserve me, God, I take refuge in you. I say to the Lord, you are my God. O Lord, it is you who are my portion and cup.
Show us, Lord, the path of life.
I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel, who even at night directs my heart. I keep the Lord ever in my sight. Since he is at my right hand, I shall stand firm. Response: Show us, Lord, the path of life. And so my heart rejoices, my soul is glad, even my body shall rest in safety. For you will not leave my soul among the dead, nor let your beloved know decay. Response:
Show us, Lord, the path of life.
You will show me the path of life, the fullness of joy in the presence of your right hand, happiness forever. Response:
Show us, Lord, the path of life.
A reading taken from 1 Peter. If you are acknowledging as your father one who has no favorites and judges everyone according to what he has done, you must be scrupulously careful as long as you are living away from your home. Remember, the ransom that was paid to free you from the useless way of life your ancestors handed down was not paid in anything corruptible, neither in silver nor gold, but in the precious blood of a lamb without spot or stain, namely Christ, who, though known since before the world was made, has been revealed only in our time, the end of the ages, for your sake. Through him you now have faith in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory for that very reason, so that you would have faith and hope in God. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Gospel Acclamation. Alleluia, Alleluia. Lord Jesus, explain the Scriptures to us. Make our hearts burn within us as you talk to us. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel. According to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Two of the disciples of Jesus were on their way to a village called Emmaus, 7 miles from Jerusalem, and they were talking together about all that had happened. Now as they talked this over, Jesus himself came up and walked by their side, but something prevented them from recognizing him. He said to them, "What matters are you discussing as you walk along?" They stopped short, their faces downcast. Then one of them, called Cleopas, answered him, "You must be the only person staying in Jerusalem who does not know the things that have been happening there these last few days." "What things?" he asked. "All about Jesus of Nazareth," they answered, "who proved he was a great prophet by the things he said and did in the sight of God and of the whole people, and how our chief priests and our leaders handed him over to be sentenced to death and had him crucified. Our own hope had been that he would be the one to set Israel free. And this is not all. 2 whole days have gone by since it all happened, and some women from our group have astounded us. They went to the tomb in the early morning, and when they did not find the body, they came back to tell us they had seen a vision of angels who declared he was alive. Some of our friends went to the tomb and found everything exactly as the women had reported, but of him they saw nothing." Then he said to them, "You foolish man, so slow to believe the full message of the prophets. Was it not ordained that the Christ should suffer and so enter into his glory?" Then, starting with Moses and going through all the prophets, he explained to them the passages throughout the scriptures that were about himself. When they drew near to the village to which they were going, he made as if to go on, but they pressed him to stay with them. "It is nearly evening," they said, "and the day is almost over." So he went in to stay with them. Now while he was with them at the table, he took the bread and said the blessing. Then he broke it and handed it to them, and their eyes were open, and they recognized him, but he had vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, "Did not our hearts burn within us as he talked to us on the road and explained the scriptures to us?" They set out that instant and returned to Jerusalem. There they found the 11 assembled together with their companions, who said to them, "Yes, it is true. The Lord has risen and has appeared to Simon." Then they told the story of what had happened on the road and how they had recognized him at the breaking of bread. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
If our Lord Jesus Christ is studied for only his history, then there's nothing special about that. If our Lord Jesus Christ is studied as a resurrected Lord with a historical life, then there's something very special about this matter. And if our Lord resurrected appeared to St. Peter and St. Peter and the apostles had a new lease of life, a life that is strong, a life that is doing exploits for God, then there's something very special about the resurrected Lord with a historical life. This means that as we follow the resurrected Lord with a historical life to show us, our faith cannot be just a faith that speaks of only a historical person. Our faith has to be more than the expression and explanation of history. Our faith will have to find expression in this life and a divine trend, a divine approach to this life. For many, solitude can be difficult. But Christians will find solitude with a great purpose, a sacredness of purpose in being held at home, solitude. Saint Peter spent some time in jail, in solitude, and they were singing praises to God in solitude. And after they were released, Saint Peter, who knew his God, became strong and do exploits. He exceeded the expectations of his parents. He exceeded the expectations of his grandparents. He was strong and he did exploits. Our Lady, the mother of Jesus, a young teenager, became strong and do exploits. She too exceeded the expectations of her parents, Saint Joachim and Saint Anne, who would realize that at the end of her life, she would be assumed into heaven. Who would realize this young, simple peasant girl from a pious family would be the mother of the church and the mother of God. She exceeded human expectations. When people deny greatness, when people do not even blink an eye on what we do, it's not a big deal. Because when we perform the smallest acts, for God, it can be something big in His eyes. This is what human expectations would come. What achievements have you done, performed? What success story will you tell us? For the world, the success story is very common. Power, fame, wealth, status. But for God, the success story is to have a faith to declare above human expectations. When we declare our faith above human expectations, then we will do something. They can astound many, many people and even the souls of heaven and the saints of heaven. To exceed expectations means that the world has a standard of thinking. The world has a standard of achievement. But surpassing all the standards of achievement and thinking, we come to realize in the resurrected Lord, no one can actually perform such a great miracle, only God the Father. In today's gospel, we have Cleopas who asked Jesus, "Did you not know the happenings?" By the way, Cleopas means glory to the Father. And it is important and significant to realize that Jesus' life, his passion, his death, and his resurrection is giving glory to his Father. And so we come to realize that our faith cannot be kept hidden. Our faith has to declare, even in solitude, we find the sacred purpose of examining our lives, of reflecting our lives in preparation for the great event, a life after life. This will exceed human expectations. Nobody wants to die. Definitely, we all want to live. But to live a resurrected life with our Lord, a life that is resurrected by the power of His Father, is a life not just looking back to the past, but a life of going forward, looking forward, doing what exceeds human expectations. The many miracles of our Lord Jesus Christ exceeded, astounded, and even deeply impressed people, from the doctors of the law, right to the government official, the centurion, right to the very people who are lepers, blind, deaf, maimed, and those diseased. Astounding all of them, Jesus performed all this to the glory of his Father. Believe in the book of Daniel chapter 11, they that know their God shall be strong and do exploits. So we will think what our Lord would have us think. to the glory of the Father. What we think, how we think, what we do, how we do, the activities, the speech, the declaration, all must have the dimension of faith. Faith above human standards. Faith above human expectations. Faith to the glory of the Father. As our Lord, the historical life, showed us how to do it, how to live a life to the glory of His Father. Prayer of the faithful. In today's gospel, we read how the disciples who met Jesus on the road to Emmaus recognized him at the breaking of the bread. As we rejoice in the resurrection, we pray that our eyes too should see and believe the faithful Lord. We pray for non-believers and those who have lost faith in God, that as they journey through their daily lives, they too may meet up with Jesus and have their eyes open to the marvelous gifts that have been bestowed on us in life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who have lost loved ones during this time of crisis and who have been unable to be with them, grieve for them, and be comforted by friends and community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all doctors, health workers, and carers who are at great personal risk and sacrifice, attending to the needs of victims of this devastating global pandemic. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our senior citizens and particularly those in nursing and retirement homes. We pray that our loving Father look down on them with compassion and inspire those who care for them to bring them safely through this very difficult period. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our church leaders, bishops and priests, that they show the courage and dedication of the apostles to the spreading of the good news of the resurrection and, like Jesus, embraced the marginalized and those who have suffered in the past from isolation and disrespect in the church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We bow our heads and remember in silence our own personal prayer. Father, may your love and compassion be constantly with us in our lives, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through goodness we have this bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us our bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name and for the good of all His holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church. And as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord,
God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna
in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life in the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed
be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
A prayer for protection from COVID-19. Pope Francis prayer. O Mary, you shine continuously on our journey as a sign of salvation and hope. We entrust ourselves to you, health of the sick. At the foot of the cross, you participated in Jesus' pain with steadfast faith. You are refuge and our hope, know what we need. We are certain that you will provide, so that as you did at Cana at Galilee, joy in feasting my return of this after this moment of trial. Help us, Mother of Divine Love, to conform ourselves to the Father's will and to do what Jesus tells us. He who took our sufferings upon himself and bore our sorrows to bring us to the cross, to the joy of the resurrection. Amen. Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.